Hello students, good news for all bank aspirants. IBPS PO, IBPS RRB, Regional Rural Banks, Officer Scale 1 and Office Assistants have reopened their registration links. So what does this mean? In case you missed out applying earlier in the given window, now this is a golden opportunity for you. You can apply now. Second, vacancies have increased for the posts of IBPS Probationary Officer, RRB Officer Scale 1 and Office Assistant. Let us spend some time understanding who all can apply and what the increase in number of vacancies. Missed out applying earlier for bank exams. Apply now. This is a very golden opportunity for all the students who missed out applying earlier. Supplementary notification has been released by offer the post of Officer Scale 1, Office Assistants for RRBs and Probationary Officer / Management Trainees for IBPS PO MT 2020. Now look at the dates here. IBPS RRB PO and Clerk, you can apply from 26th October till 9th November. This is the registration window. For IBPS PO or Management Trainee, from 28th October to 11th November. The closing date for Gramina Banks is 9th November and closing dates for Probationary Officer is 11th November. For RRB Officer Scale 1 and Office Assistant for both the posts, 9th November is the last date. Right? In case if you have not applied earlier, you can apply now. We will see who all can apply. Who all can apply? That is the most important question. Sir, can I apply? I have already applied. What should I do? There are many questions from students. So, let us get this very clear. I will take it up. Right? Let me go in order. IBPS Probationary Officer and Management Trainees who attained eligibility in terms of education qualifications by 11th November 2020. Be very clear. They are very specifically mentioned in the notification. That means you are a graduate. You attained the desired education qualification as on 11th November. Then you are eligible to apply. All of you know, because of this COVID pandemic situation, exams of final years, final semester or final year graduation were postponed, right? So, as on date mentioned in the earlier application, most of you are not eligible. Most of the final year students or final semester students were not eligible. Now, all those final year students have now become eligible to apply for IBPS PO, IBPS RRB PO Scale 1 and IBPS RRB Office Assistants, right? Your education qualification, there is no change in age. Age as on date mentioned in the actual notification only. But here, this as on 11th November, if you are attained the desired education qualification, you can apply. Then, who could not, the second category is who could not register successfully from 5th August to 26th August. If you are not registered or your registration was not successful, then you can apply for this particular thing once again as per the dates given in the supplementary notification. Then Officer Scale 1 and Office Assistants for Regional Rural Banks 2020, who have attained the education qualification, that means if you attend the desired education qualification as on 9th November, then you are eligible. That means those who are in final year students, they are eligible now. As on 9th November, if you are attaining that desired qualification, then you can apply for this post. Who could not register successfully from the earlier window, 1st July to 21st July was the earlier window in the actual notification. If you missed out applying that, or in case your registration was not successful, in either of these cases, you can apply once again. This is an important note now. That's what I am trying to tell you. Who all can apply? See, this note will clear all your doubts. All those who had applied successfully during the registration window in July/August. That means if you see here, August, there is a window for IBPS PO. In July, there is a specific window for Officer Scale 1 and Office Assistant. If you applied successfully during those windows and were called for the online preliminary exam for these posts during September, October 2020 for a particular post, should not apply for that post. That means, see, there are two scenarios. One, you applied successfully. Your registration is successful. You called for the exam. You appeared for the exam, you have not appeared for the exam, that doesn't matter. right? Your registration was successful. You were called for the examination. You appeared, you're not appeared. Doesn't matter. You are not eligible to apply. Keep that point in mind. This is a very, very important point. Right? In case you have not applied earlier or your registration was not successful, yes, this is a golden opportunity. Again, it will not come. So, why I'm saying, you please go ahead and apply. Let us look at the dates of these preliminary exams. If you take your IBPS PO or management trainees, this supplementary advertisement, those who all apply now, will have their examination on 5th January and 6th January prelim exam. For officer scale 1, exam will be on 31st December, and office assistant exam will be on 2nd January and 4th January. So these are your prelim exam dates. Call letter download will be made available 10 days before the exam date. That means exam date 10 days before, let's say 31st December is the exam of officer scale 1. 10 days before, that means from 21st December onwards, call letter will be made available. You have to download. We have discussed that. The second good news is vacancies have increased. For probationary officers, IBPS, PO and management trainees, there is an increase of 2,100 posts. Tremendous increase, 2,100. And the total number of posts are now 3,517. Now, we are telling you from day one, the notification was out. Maybe RRB PO notification, RRB office assistant notification, or IBPS PO notification. Please, if you are eligible as per age and education qualifications, please do apply. Don't keep in mind the number of vacancies. We got plenty of mails and queries from students saying, sir, there are only 1400 vacancies, there are only 1200 vacancies. Do we need to apply? Can we be there in the merit list? See, forget all those. We are telling you from the beginning, definitely, if you look at the notification, there are banks which are not reported. Please keep that point in mind. They are not saying zero. They have not reported their vacancy. That means they have not, because of this merger, they have not assessed the strength till now. Maybe next, till your result is out, they can, all 1 month before or 15 days before also, they may announce their vacancies. So don't keep that numbers, smaller number in mind, and don't, if you are not applying, I am saying you have made a mistake. Now, there is a chance to rectify your mistake. Again, the links have been reopened. Please, the posts have also been increased. Please, we request you, please do apply. Don't make that mistake, right? So, total number of posts have increased by 2,100 by Canara Bank. Total is coming around 3,517 posts. Two major banks, Indian Bank and Punjab National Bank, they have not yet reported their vacancies. In future, they may report maybe 500, maybe 1,000, maybe 2,100, 2,500 or 3,000, we don't know. So, definitely there is a fair chance that this number may go up in the future, right? Then, officer scale 1 and office assistant. Now, each category, if you say officer scale 1, there is an increase of 400 posts, and office assistant, there was an increase of 400. Total, there is an increase of 800. Now, the total number of posts is 9,200 plus. I am saying this will also go up in the near future, right? So, those who are not applied, please do apply. This is a golden opportunity. Now, what do we offer for this bank exam coaching? You have exam on 31st December and you are having exam in what you call 2nd and 4th January and 6th January. So, we see what we offer. We are offering a 3-month course, 6-month course and 1-year course for bank exams 2020. Now, if you see a 3-month course, the price at ₹3,950, 6-month course price at ₹5,450, 1-year course price at ₹7,750. Now, if you look at number of classes, 250 hours, 250 hours, 250 hours, basically 125 classes you will be getting as a part of the course. Out of these 125, 95 will for your prelim exam and 30 classes for your main examination. So, this coaching, it may be 3-month course or 6-month course or 1-year course. It is a combined course which will take care of your preparation for both prelim and your main examination. So, each class is of 2 hours duration, 125 into 2, 250 hours. We are not ready. There is no change in number of classes. You take either 3-month variant or a 6-month variant or a 1-year variant or 1-year course, a 3-month course or 6-month course, your number of classes, number of hours are going to remain same, right? That's a major advantage. Now, let us look at the changes. You can see, observe the changes in this particular thing, validity of videos. 3 month course videos are valid up to 4 months, 6 month course up to 6 months, 1 year course up to 12 months. That means after 4 months, if you have enrolled for 3 month course, from the date of enrollment, once you have completed 4 months, you cannot watch those videos. Your videos will be expired. 6 months course, after 6 months, your videos will be expired. You cannot watch them. 1 year course, after 12 months, the videos will be expired. But within this stipulated time of 4 months or 6 months or 12 months, you can watch those videos any number of times on your mobile app. Then study material booklet, there is no change. 11 e-booklets in all the three courses. Then validity of student homepage. If you see here, validity of videos is different from validity of student homepage. Here for 3 month course, validity of videos is 4 months, but validity of student homepage is 6 months. We have increased the validity of student homepage because students prepare, watch videos, and they have to practice sectional test and mock test. That is why the validity of student homepage for 3 month course is 6 months, for 6 month course is 12 months, and 1 year course is 18 months. That means within that particular period, you can write your sectional test, you can write your full length sectional test, topic wise sectional test, you can take your mock test, and you will get remaining all features are available. Maybe you take your test taking strategies presentation, or your computer knowledge presentation, or your daily test, or your weekly GK updates, everything, daily GF, everything is available on your student homepage within that, till that particular period, right? Now, look at number of tests. Topic wise sectional test is same, 144, 144, 144 across all three courses. But full length sectional test, there is a different. 3 month course, you are having 10 full length sectional tests. Full length is nothing but all topics together, right? It is equal, it is completely equal to one particular section. 20 full length sectional for 6 month course and 50 full length sectional tests for your 1 year course. This is one thing which you need to pay attention. Then there is a difference in the number of mock tests. 3 month course, you'll be getting 30 mock tests. 6 month course, you'll be getting 75 mock tests. And 1 year course, you'll be getting 130 comprehensive mock tests for 1 year course, right? So if you want to write this sectional test, if you want to practice this mock test, you want to revise once again, right? You want to analyze the mock test. That is why they've increased your validity of student homepage. 6 months, 12 months, and 18 months. Validity of videos is different. Validity of student homepage is different. Then Current Affair Cracker Magazine. We are uploading e-magazine of Current Affairs. It's known as Current Affair Cracker on your homepage. 3 month course, you'll get total 6 issues of this e-booklet. 6 month course, you'll get 12 issues of the magazine. And 1 year course, you'll be getting 18 issues of this e-magazine on your homepage. So these are basically the differences. You can see the basic difference. Maybe number of classes, there is no change. Study material and topic wise sectional test, there is no change. You can observe the difference in the validity of videos and validity of your student homepage, two major things. And full length sectional test and mock test and current affair cracker, the number of tests you are getting, there is a difference. But coverage wise, the number of classes you are going to get will be same. But one point is, if you are joining, if you are taking a 3 month course, you will be having daily 2 classes, that means 4 hours. Otherwise, you will not be. 125 classes means you need to complete the syllabus in 3 months. So daily, you will be having daily 2 classes. So daily 4 hours, you will be getting, right? So that's the only option for 3 month course. 6 month and 1 year course, you have different things to choose from, that you can see from our website. Thank you, students. Hope this information is helpful. So stay home, stay safe, prepare with time classes. Thank you so much.